The final match of the day. The sole competing Yokozuna Hakuho from the right side, 2-1. His only blemish on day 2 against Daitei Sho. That was his 23rd Kimoshi giveaway. Yokozuna losing to Hiramaki, ranked in final. His opponent is Okinomi. Okinomi 1-2 this special. Overall, these two have fought 21 times. Hako leads 20-1. Hako won the first 12 of their series, and Okinomi won one match. The one victory for Okinomi came in the 2015 September Basho, so that's well over 4 years ago. After that, Hakuho has put together 8 straight wins. But again, you never want to count anybody out, because anything could happen in sumo. We've seen it happen so many times. Hakuho knows that no matter how many times he's beaten Okinomi, he cannot take the veteran lightly. Because Okinomi, remember, he had a nice 11-4 record. Okinomi was in contention till the last day. He got eliminated on the final day when he lost to Taka Geisho. But Okinomi almost won the championship in the last tournament, so he is as good as any opponent that Hakuho will be facing, will face this basho. 2-1 Hakuho was saying that I cannot have any letdowns from the day 2 loss. So yesterday he came strong and showed a powerful performance against Shinko Musubi Asano Yama, opening up with a right hand slap and getting his, not the usual grip, but the left hand inside grip, and then followed up with the right hand inside, got the Morozashi double inside grip in the end before beating Asano Yama. But that was some determined sumo, relentless attack by Hakuho yesterday. That's what makes this man so good. Doesn't lose on back-to-back days. Shows no letdowns. That said, Hakuho has been the gold standard in sumo for many, many years, but these recent years, Hakuho personally admits that he's been sitting on the sidelines quite a few times, and he hasn't been quite as dominant as he used to be. So anybody has a chance. And hey, Okinomi might be 1-20 against Hakuho, but Okinomi certainly has a chance to knock off Hakuho on any given day. So Okinomi licking his lips, hoping for his second win over Hakuho. And yet another Kimoshi. So Ichiban, the final match of day 4. It is Hakuho and Okinomi. As I always say, there are so many weapons and so few ways to stop Hakuho. Okinomi, hey, same thing can be said for Okinomi too. Okinomi is a seasoned veteran. Widely veteran, I must say, and he has many tricks and moves up his sleeve. Here we go, the final match. Hakuho tries to get the shot again. Okinomi prevents Hakuho from getting that. Okinomi goes for the right hand, it doesn't work. Hakuho gets the grip, drops his hips. Okinomi looks down at Morozashi double inside. Hakuho tries to punch Okinomi, but Okinomi not going anywhere. Hakuho Kinomi certainly gave Hakuho a serious run for his money. Kinomi did not win the Joe Proton. He has certainly excited the crowd. Matenage. Hakuho, really countered, turned the tables at the edge. And that's why he is the Yokozuna. 3-1. Tomorrow he fights Myogiryu. Okinomi 1-3. Okinomi versus Mitakeumi on day 5. Hakuho, his plan was to simply get that left hand shadow outside. He's broken over. He wasn't able to get it. Hakuho attacks. Okinomi does a nice job of preventing Hakuho from forcing him out by slipping both arms inside. Now Okinomi gets the golden opportunity right here, attacks Hakuho, but Hakuho with a strong hand. The good thing was Hakuho tries to trip him up. Good thing for Hakuho was he had that shallow grip outside. If he was a deep outside grip, it probably didn't work. But since his grip was shallow and nice and tight, he was able to execute the Watanage in the end. Look at this, Okinomi goes in for the kill, but Hakuho turns the table. What a move at the edge. Hakuho flexes his muscles, and Hakuho executes. Beautiful, effective Watanage at the 11th hour. Okinomi almost, but came close, but no cigar for Okinomi. Again, Hakuho resists, gets set. Hakuho, that left hand is the lethal weapon. Hakuho comes out on top. Again, even though Okinomi lost, Hakuho says,